The newly reconstituted association says it will have to go through the Ministry of Social Transformation to hold a press conference to denounce the old board. Cheryl Clark, who also served on the old executive, has been elected president again. She says the new executive wants the people of Wilton's Yard to assist one another for the right reasons as they move forward.
We have a lot of changes that has been made on that board, and we definitely have to make it known because we don't want people going on a side doing whatever they want to do using it under the Wilton's Yard Association. Because what we're trying, the image we have and what we're trying to do is not to encourage, but to help the less fortunate. Let's do it for love. Let's do it because we want to do it to help the people. We want to see the people get somewhere and not to just get it for our purposes or our own gain.
The new association came together to clean up part of the community on the weekend as a first project. The assistant secretary says this is just one project among many that the association plans to undertake.
Because we are not really official as yet, but we're trying to do what we can to help the children in the community and also the people in the community, because they really need our help also too. And we have a lot of parents that just sit down in the yard. We need to put them out, let them bring back the vibrant stuff. So we're trying our best with them.
We have been cleaning there more than once, but you know, it's just the kind of character people that live there. You find that they're not somewhere people to keep it up of the cleanliness. So you find every time we look down that alley where we're standing right now, we are standing at the back of the community center facing that place. I mean, it is really not a good scenery for the kids or anybody for the matter of fact.
The executive says a number of parents are assisting, but they want all residents to come together anytime they undertake a project so the association can survive this time around. For the DBS News World, Brian Calixte reporting.